So, what are we gonna do next? Another Silent Hill video?
What's left to review? We already did them all.
You didn't review all of the Silent Hill games.
I'm not reviewing Alchemilla. It's a fan game. If I'm gonna hurt someone's feelings, they gotta be making some money.
What about that new gamble machine?
The patchy slot? They put a bunch of Silent Hill 2 ripoff cutscenes on a slot machine. You push the buttons and you put money in, and sometimes the money comes back out. There's my review of the patchy slot machine.
Yeah, who cares about that? As long as it's keeping them from making any more games, let them do what they want. It's not like it affects the rest of the series or anything.
You could review Silent Hill Arcade Machine.
I wish.
Yeah, somebody made an emulator for it last year.
What did you just say to me? Huh? What? Silent Hill the Arcade, previously only available in Japan and Europe, was dumped from an arcade machine by someone on Silent Hill Heaven Forum and made playable on an arcade emulator by some guy at a blog called Insert More Coins in 2014. We're using a Wii Remote input driver and pretending it was ported to the Wii like it should have been years ago. The game is exactly what we all thought it was going to be, a light gun shooter just like every other light gun shooter in existence. It's House of the Dead, but with a Silent Hill skin. So for the sort of people who like this sort of game, this is the sort of game they'll like.
But it's not inconsequential. It's got its own canonical premise and story.
All of this could be one of Ryan's pranks, but it's not, is it?
That would be awesome. Then all I need to do is beat the living daylights out of him.
The game was developed and released in Japan in July of 2007, after Team Silent disbanded, but before Origin started the Western trend of copying Silent Hill 2 over and over, so the only other Silent Hill games at the time were 1-4. Is Silent Hill Arcade the elusive Japanese-produced Silent Hill game of legend, untainted by the filthy hands of Gaijin developers? Almost. If only it weren't a light gun shooter.
And if only it weren't copying Silent Hill 2 again. Of course it's copying Silent Hill 2 again. It's the only other game in the series.
Little Baroness.
The story of Silent Hill Arcade is based on the Little Baroness memo from Toluca Prison, which is about Dakota Fanning ending up in the hospital dying of tuberculosis.
Hana, I brought you a friend today.
Whoa, thank you! But it's all right. Okay, thank you.
Her mother just can't watch her suffer.
I just couldn't watch you suffer.
So she takes her for a ride on the Little Baroness and chucks her over the edge just before the boat disappears. That must have been the part that was ripped out of the magazine.
What went wrong, Hana? Why are you crying?
I can't find my mommy. Maybe she doesn't like me anymore. That's why she did such a thing.
Do you hate your mommy, Hana? It's the same with your mommy. She would never dislike you.
Years later, some kid and his friends go to Silent Hill just because it would be way cool. One of them is a college girl visiting her 6-year-old pen pal who lives in Silent Hill and gets possessed by Dakota Fanning's ghost and runs all around while the kids chase her.
What? Hey, what happened? A boat whistle?
Ow! My head!
A bunch of them get captured by monsters, and you have to rescue them.
What's that all about? What is happening? I can't stand it anymore! But Jesse!
Tina!
Jesse!
I'm alive?
I'm so glad!
Wait, they're getting attacked by monsters, but they don't have to face their own inner demons? Does that mean the monsters are in the real world?
Good luck getting that one to stick with the canon Nazis. So anyway, then you find out this one kid is the great-grandson of the Little Baroness's captain.
Very old picture, isn't it?
He's my great-grandfather.
What?
He was the captain of the sightseeing ship in this town.
So that's apparently why he was brought to the town, so he could complete the captain's unfinished business and put Dakota Fanning's soul to rest.
It's all right now. The nightmare is over.
So it's the most stereotypical ghost story you could think of, and none of it has any real significance with the rest of the series. But what do you expect? It's an arcade game.
The game was produced and directed by a bunch of guys who make arcade games for Konami, which doesn't surprise me. So why should it surprise you? Are you surprised? Ew.
One of the producers is Shigenobu Matsuyama, the guy who got fired from producing Metal Gear Rising. And one of the directors, Hiroyuki Ashida, directed the Gradius 4 arcade game, which could be why Silent Hill Arcade has the best UFO ending of them all.
Emily and Hana have both fallen in my hands. If you want them back, come chasing after me to the end of the universe!
Hurry, we have to go after them in this space combat ship.
What?
Silent Hill Arcade's gameplay is pretty fun for what it is.
There are branching paths.
Look, there are two doors. Which one should we go through? Or we could keep going further down here.
Extra weapons. And enemies that give secret bonuses when killed.
It's pretty long for an arcade machine, but Konami arcade machines in Japan work with something called an e-amusement pass, which gives access to online leaderboards and allows players to save their progress.
As of April 6, 2015, someone named USK holds the top single-player score for Silent Hill Arcade in all of Japan, made on a machine somewhere inside this Taito station in Nagoya.
The enemies in the game are all ripped straight from Silent Hill 2 through 4, except for three original bosses. One of them is a big flying mummy with blades for hands.
Come get me if you want!
It's fast!
And another was Scarlet before Scarlet was Scarlet. Scarlet? The final boss is Dakota Fanning's true form. None of the other enemies, Pyramid Head especially, have any contextual basis. They aren't relevant to the characters in the game, but who cares, it's a light gun shooter. Fuzh?
What?
Someone's at the door.
Where?
The front door.
Silent Hill Arcade is based on Silent Hill 2, so you end up playing through familiar areas from Silent Hill 2.
Look at this. I found it under the prison.
Though once you get onto the Little Baroness at the end, it turns into the Silent Hill 3 shopping mall for no good reason.
I have never been to a shopping mall that I've wanted to leave so quickly.
Yeah, really.
Our guess is the people making the game didn't know it wasn't located in Silent Hill.
What kind of world is this?
Are we inside Emily's memory?
Fuzh! Answer!
Answer what?
Door! What was that all about?
I think the ghost of Danny Glover just delivered us a package.
Pre-braces or post-braces, Danny Glover?
Who's the package from?
It says it's from Silent Hill.
The town or the people in the town? All the people in the town sent us a package?
It doesn't say, it just says Silent Hill.
You can't send a package without a return address.
Well, apparently you can, because somebody did, and there it is. So just open it.
I don't know, what if someone from the wiki sends us an ID or something?
Happy birthday, but it's not my birthday.
Do we review this?
We can't review it. We don't have a Vita.
Nobody does.
I have a Vita.
I think if you had to pare down one thing to look forward to, it's the story because I wrote it. People are gonna be so pissed.